Richie Fiore talks about starting Buffalo Springfield. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Music. Richie Fiore has a brand new album out. It's called 50th Anniversary, Return to the Troubadour. A two-CD set. The first set is various tune. It's called Still Deliverin'. And set two, as he plays the Poco album Deliverin' from start to finish, that one's called Deliverin' Again. Here's our second interview with former Buffalo Springfield Poco and Souther Hillman Fiore band member, Richie Fiore.
It's interesting, though, on that first album, it seemed like a well-thought... When you say that about Stephen and Neil, I remember my reaction listening to the first album going, you know, this just seems like a well-thought-out idea. I don't know why I thought that, but I just thought I loved it so much.
Well, interestingly enough, when Neil came past to New York, Stephen already met him on his way to California and met him up in Toronto. He and Bruce were playing up there. And then they came down to New York where we had an apartment and we you know, had maintained this for a while. And Neil taught me nowadays Clancy can't even sing. And so, you know, I loved the song. It was an interesting song. It was an intricate song, but all. And so when I got to California after, you know, I'd heard The Byrds' first record that Graham Parsons brought up to, you know, and I was living up in Connecticut working at Pratt & Whitney Aircraft. And I said, man, I got to get back into music. Well, when I got to California, Stephen had all of these songs that he wrote already done. And so we just sat in a little apartment and just learned these songs. And then we kind of learned Nowadays Clancy Can't Even Sing together. And so, because I was teaching it to him, but I think he was familiar with the song as well. But so when that little moment on Sunset Boulevard arrived and happened, you know, where Neil and Bruce were actually on their way out of town to leave Los Angeles, they couldn't find us, you know. It just seemed natural that when we all got together that there was a band. But Stephen had written all those songs, and so we had already become a vocal entity, you know, singing. Even we modeled some things after the Lennon and McCartney singing unison deal, you know, like you listen to Sit Down, I Think I Love You, and songs like that. So Stephen and I would try some of that as well. And so but the fact that he had these songs already written, it was pretty amazing, because Neil, who also is a very prolific songwriter, you know, he had, I think, most of the songs already done too, that we started to learn when we said, hey, you want to be in a band? So it's, you know, these things just kind of evolve.
Yeah. Well, when you were a pastor, weren't people coming up to you and say, hey, aren't you? Well, mind you, they all probably knew, anybody in your congregation knew your past, right? But weren't they asking you, what's that?
Some, not all.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
I know, but see, I get this a lot from people. They'll go, what's this little old me? And I'm going, little old me who was in Buffalo Springfield and formed Poco. There's no little old me there to me.
You know? Yeah. Oh, there were definitely some that knew and visited our church. But, you know, you'd be surprised. I mean, there were some. I mean, I just had somebody even talk to me about that, you know, at church just a couple weeks ago or so. You know, I really didn't have a clue as to who you were, you know, or what you were doing, you know, but now I know.
Make sure you comment on our video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. If you want to donate to the channel, there's a link at the very top of the description. Buy a t-shirt if you like. That helps support our channel as well. We recently hit 80,000 subscribers. Thank you for that. More from Richie Fiore coming up in the next 3-4 days. I'm John Bowden. Make sure you comment on our video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. This is Rock History Music. Take care of yourself.